inside the core of the puck, we have placed a magnet so that when the entire puck has crossed the goal line, we can triangulate its position using magnetometers. So these Hall effect sensors, or magnetometers, will be able to detect the position based on where it is in the net. So if there's one up here, it'll say this is a certain distance away from there, certain height away, and a certain depth, so that we can figure out whether the entire puck has crossed the goal line.
So the problem that we're addressing for our project is highway lights on the highway at night. So since, for safety purposes, the lights on a highway have to be on all night, but cars aren't always on the highway all night long. So we wanted to come up with a project that could make the lights go on and off depending on whether or not there was a car on the highway at that time.
With the many light bulbs in our circuit, we did not have enough voltage through the Arduino to power all the light bulbs. So what we had to do is, for each of the light bulbs, we made in its own circuit. We had a battery pack and a transistor with all the cords going into the Arduino.
The way it works basically is that we have a battery and a fan hooked up. So the way this works is that the battery obviously has a positive and negative end, and the fan also has a positive and negative end. So as we hook it up, as we hook up the positive and negative end, the fan starts spinning and it blows the air into this funnel, which condenses the air and makes it a higher pressure into the skirt. And as I've explained, the skirt, as you will see, the skirt lifts up and it blows in through a layer of air to allow the hovercraft to have less friction over the ground.
Our project was inspired by the lines at an amusement park and how long it takes to get onto a ride. Usually when you're waiting in line, there's always those signs that tell you how long it is to get onto the ride from that point. But there are always some errors.
Starts with the input from the rotary encoders, which basically tell the Arduino how many people are in a line at a given time. So the rotary encoders work that basically with one turn of it that tells the program one person has just entered or exited the line. So that's our first step of the program. The second step is to set variables that take those inputs and keep counting to calculate the total people in line. So it takes the number of people who entered the line and the number of people exited to calculate the total number of people in line at a given time. From the start of the program, we had a timer running, and the timer is basically used to calculate how often 10 people, which we set as the number of people per cart of the ride, how often those 10 people exit the line to board the ride. We then take that number, we then take the total number of people online divided by 10, and multiply that by the time that it takes for 10 people to exit the line to get the total wait time in that moment for anyone who's entering the line then. And that is basically the final step to our program. The output of the program that we didn't get to do yet, but hopefully will, is to use a Wi-Fi signal to send out the input, to send an output using the message of what the final wait time is to anyone at any point in the park that they can access it through email or through internet. So that was basically our main goal.
efficient track for runners. The lights and fans situated around the track will only be turned on in half of the gym at one time, thereby conserving energy. Additionally, the track will provide the athlete with runner data.
As the runner will be running, we start from here. So, we have two photoresistors, one on each side, and then there's a laser pointing at the photoresistor. So as the runner passes through the gate here, it triggers the photoresistor. And what that does, it does a couple things. For one thing, that turns on the fan, because our whole concept of our track is supposed to be energy efficient, and it's also supposed to provide helpful information. So this way, instead of having fans running the entire time, the fan only runs once you pass through the laser. And it does the same thing once you pass through this laser here. The way it's energy efficient is that the fan will shut off once you pass the area. What it will do, we're going to try to do, is have it so it's going to, as you're running, one of the other things it's going to do is it's going to be calculating. It's going to calculate your total speed as well as your average speed, and it can even calculate your half lap speed.
ABC, Auto Brightness Company, and it deals with lighting in a room. So by determining the amount of sunlight that comes through a window, the light in the room will dim or get brighter, and therefore we save energy and also save the trouble of turning on and off the light when you need to. And we achieve this by using photocells, which determine voltage, and voltage changes based on sunlight, so therefore the photocell reads the voltage, and the code on the Arduino tells like the light basically when to dim and what level to dim, and that's our project, ABC.